Me tie Doughty. There was a haunted house where every night a bloody
king big booty
fell down the chimney. At least that's what people said, so nobody would stay there overnight. Then a rich man offered
1,100 blunts
and a vacation
to whoever would do it. And Thomas said he would try if he could have Alfred with him. So it was all settled. The very next night, Thomas went to the house with
Alfred.
To make it more cheerful, he started a fire in the
cool green pasture in the mountains.
Then he sat in front of the fire and waited and waited and waited and waited.
And you wait and you wait and you wait. You wait and you...
And Alfred waited with him. For a while, nothing happened. But a little after midnight, nothing happened. Then a few minutes later, nothing happened.
Then Thomas had an idea. Let's make a doll the size of a
dead man's brain,
he said.
No,
Alfred said. Alfred, I'll throw you in the fire, said Thomas, and that'll be that.
No,
Alfred said.
I'll throw you
in the fire. So Thomas and Alfred took it out on one another.
Suddenly, the two men heard someone singing softly and sadly off in the woods. The singing sounded something like this. Me tai do di bo te. It's just somebody singing, Thomas told himself, but he was frightened. Then Alfred answered the song. Softly and sadly, he sang.
Thomas could not believe his ears.
Then a few minutes later, he heard the singing again. Now it was closer and louder, but the words were the same.
Me tai do di wo te.
This time Thomas tried to stop Alfred from answering. He was afraid that whoever was singing would hear it and fuck them. But
Alfred
paid no attention, and again he sang. A half hour later,
Thomas
heard the singing again. Now it was in the backyard, and the song was the same.
Me tai do di wo te.
Again,
Thomas tried to keep Alfred
quiet, but
Alfred
sang louder than ever. Soon
Thomas
heard the singing again. Now it was coming down the chimney. Me tai do.
Fuck.
I'm stuck. I'm stuck.
He got three.
Doughty.
Alfred
sang right back. Suddenly, a bloody
king big booty
fell out of the chimney. It missed the fire and landed right next to
Alfred. Alfred
took one look and fell over. Dead from fright.
King Big Booty
turned and stared at
Thomas. Thomas said,
I'll fuck you
in the big booty.
Slowly, it opened its mouth and